Did you ever see a psycho razor? Really, a psycho razor. Gillette made a razor, a safety razor, back in 1952 for prisons, for use in prisons and mental institutions. It's a safety razor where you can't get the blade out, and it's been affectionately nicknamed the psycho. I'm actually going to show it to you, and I'm going to shave with it today, and we'll see if the psycho still works. Stay tuned. You probably never saw one of these before. And growing up in the industry with my mother and father both cutting hair and me learning how to cut hair, and I was sweeping floors, hair off of floors when I was probably 3, 4, 5 years old. So I grew up in barbershops and salon environments, including having a barber chair in our basement. So when most kids were playing games in their basement, I was spinning in circles in a barber chair and pretending to give fake shaves to my brothers and all that kind of fun stuff. Anyways, look at this. This is a safety razor. Looks like any old safety razor, doesn't it? It says Gillette on it. See that? Okay. Now, what's different about this, watch, is this. Watch. It comes right out. What in the world? This is the key to the safety razor. This is the safety razor. This was used in prisons and mental institutions. It was a way, watch, I will unlock the top, turn it. Gotta do it again. And this comes right off. And this is now separate. You put the blade in there, put this on it. Now lock it down. You can, well, let me show you. Can you see inside there? Yeah, see that? And what it is, it's a little nut in there. And that is the key that goes in there and locks it down. Check this out. Watch. Watch it raise. See it raise a little bit? Now I'm going to tighten it up. Let me read you a little bit about this. This was made by Gillette. And then this would be with the guards or at the nurse's station while the person would shave. Now, why is this important? Because the blade can't be taken out of there without the key. You can't be cutting yourself or cutting your own throat or cutting someone else when that's locked in there tight. This is, I'm going to read something. It's an unusual item in shaving history. It's a Gillette institutional razor, otherwise known as the Psycho. They used to be used in jails and other facilities when it wasn't safe for inmates to have free access to razor blades. Duh. Without a key, it's very difficult to remove the blade from this razor. It has a trapped nut inside the handle and must be operated with a special wrench. This. These are a little more special because these are made in England. The date code of these says that they were produced in 1952, and aside from the special mechanism, it's a normal Gillette razor. They accept regular Gillette Gillette-style double-edge razor blades, which are available in a wide variety of sources. It's an interesting and unusual piece of shaving history to use or collect. Well, I'm actually going to try to shave under here today. Today's a day that I need a shave, so let's give this a shot. Now, I am a skilled barber, and I know shaving very well. Let me just kind of whip up. This is sandalwood. Oh my gosh, this smells so good. If you ever came in and got a shave from me, this is one of the products that I would be using on your face. But I'm going to whip up some lather with that. But first things first, got a towel here. Let me just unbutton this dog a little bit. All right. All right. Okay, now let's just try this here. Whip up a little bit of lather. Actually, before I do that, I need to load the razor blade. So here's a double edge right here. And these push out. Watch. Like that. I remember when I was a kid, there was always this scare that people would put razor blades in apples. Screw that off. I could be taking my life into my hands, literally, with this. So there's the blade. Put that on. Oh, look at that. It fits perfect. It's just a pretty standard Gillette. Let's lock it down. And by locking it down, it does... Whoa! Now the blade is spinning in there. Okay. Let's lock this bad boy down. Oops. So these would be kept at the guards station or the nurses station in the institution. I'm going to lock it in tight. And by tight, that means that it's pushing down, and that blade is at, can you see that angle? Okay. The blade is kind of going down on each side. This could end up being interesting and historical, or it can be very bloody. As I chuckle. Right now, I just shave underneath the beard, that's all. That noise you're hearing is my dehydrator out on the deck right now. I just made some ribeye bites. I didn't put the whole steak in there. Work that in there. All right. Now this comes right out. Now I just use it like a regular blade. Smooth. Spin it around. Use the other side. When I was a young man, this hair was all black, popping out of my top of my shirt and collar. And now that it's white, I can hardly see it. There's really no need to trim it anymore. All right, let me just go up a little bit. Let me go rinse. And we are back, all cleaned up. I'm going to put some Thayer's Witch Hazel on it, which has rose petal in it. It's got aloe. So it's the only thing that I put on my skin after shaving. Soothes it. It's an astringent. And I even put some of it in a spray bottle, and I'll kind of mist my face with it sometimes. The heck. All right. Well, did the psycho work? Yeah, it did. Smooth. Just a couple passes. Was it accurate? Let's see. Yeah. Didn't jack up my line or anything like that. You do have to be a little bit careful when you're going over cartilage, like kind of like my Adam's apple. You could end up, if you press too hard, you can end up like taking a strip of skin off right there. So, the Gillette Institutional Razor, made in England, affectionately known as the Psycho, from 1952, works perfect. Two thumbs up. I'll put a link for this down below. Once you use this after shaving, you will never use anything else ever again. Nothing with fragrances. It's perfect. It's natural. You are going to love it. The Psycho.
Thank you.